today we solve a problem of thin shells which is covering maximum quantities. I'll read the problem. A cylindrical thin drum 800 mm in a diameter and 3 meter long has a shell thickness of 10 mm. If the drum is subjected to an internal pressure of 2.5 newton per mm square, determine number 1 the change in diameter, number 2 change in length, and number 3 change in volume. Given E is equal to 2 into 10 to the power 5 newton per mm square and Poisson's ratio is 1/4. So let's start solution of the problem. First of all, write the given things or data which is given in the problem. So start, cylindrical thin drum which is having diameter 800 mm. So diameter of the drum is given as 800 mm, and the length of the drum, I'll denote by capital L, is given as 3 meters, or if I want to write it in millimeter, it will be 3000 millimeter. Shell thickness small t is 10 mm, and the internal pressure which is acting in the drum is 2.5 newton per mm square. So now first we have to calculate the change in diameter, change in length, and change in volume. We have to calculate the changes which happen in the cylindrical thin drum. So for solving this, initially we have to calculate the two kinds of stresses, that is circumferential stress and longitudinal stress in the thin shell. So let's first calculate the circumferential or it is also known as hoop stress, which is denoted by the symbol sigma 1. One suffix will generally use with the circumferential or hoop values, sigma 1 PD divided by 2T. PD divided by 2T. Now put the values. Sigma 1 is equal to P 2.5 800 10. So I'll get sigma 1 as 100 newton per mm square. Now let's calculate second thing, that is the longitudinal stress. Longitudinal stress will generally denote by the symbol sigma 2 PD by 4T, or I can write it as like this, PD by 2T into 1/2. So initially we calculated PD by 2T here, that is 100. So I will write 100 into 1/2, so it will be 50. So I'll get sigma 2 as 50 newton per mm square. Sigma 2 50 newton per mm square. So we have calculated the two stresses, longitudinal stress and circumferential stress, which is generated in the thin shells. Now the next thing that we have to calculate is the circumferential strain. As I told you, we will use the suffix 1 for circumferential quantities. Therefore, I will write it as E1, E for strain, circumferential strain, E1. And we know thus that this is given by the formula sigma 1 by E minus mu into sigma 2 by E. Sigma 1 and sigma 2 we already calculated. E is given in the problem and mu is nothing but the Poisson's ratio. So what I'll do, I'll take E1 by E as common, then I will write sigma 1 minus mu into sigma 2. E1 1 upon 2 into 10 to the power 5 sigma 1 100 minus mu is 0.25 into sigma 2 50. So we'll get E1, that is circumferential strain, 4.375. After calculating, we'll get 4.375 into 10 to the power minus 4. So this is the circumferential strain. Now let's calculate longitudinal strain. Longitudinal strain, I'll denote it by E2, is, now it is given by the formula sigma 2 by E minus mu into sigma 1 by E. Now once again, I'll take 1 by E common, sigma 2 minus mu into sigma 1. So E2, 1 by E, 1, 2 into 10 to the power 5, sigma 2 is 50, okay, we already calculated minus mu, 0.25 into sigma 1 is 100. So we'll get the longitudinal strain as 1.25 into 10 to the power minus 4. After calculation, we'll get this value. So still we calculated four things here: circumferential or hoop stress, longitudinal stress, then circumferential strain and longitudinal strain. We have calculated stresses and strains in the thin shells. But we know that the longitudinal strain is nothing but the strain which is generated along the length of the thin shell. So longitudinal strain, here we used the symbol E2, is given by another formula. E2 is nothing but the change in length divided by original length. As strain is change in dimension to the original dimension, so here longitudinal strain is change in length of thin shell to the original length. Therefore, change in length delta L is equal to E2 into L. And now E2 we already calculated, that is 1.25 10 to the power minus 4 into length of the cylinder as 3000 in millimeter. So we will get change in the length which is asked to calculate, that is change in the length as 0.375 mm. After calculation, we will get this as 0.375. I'll make it as a box. Okay. Now once again, we initially calculated that circumferential strain. Okay. So I'll use another formula of circumferential strain. We denoted by the symbol E1, and we already calculated here E1, 4.375 into 10 to the power minus 4. Okay. But it is nothing but the strain generated along the diameter of the thin shell. Therefore, we write E1 is equal to change in diameter of the shell divided by original diameter, delta D by D. And I am interested in calculating change in diameter, delta D is equal to E1 into D. So delta D, E1, 4.375 into 10 to the power minus 4, and diameter of the shell as 800 millimeter. So I'll get delta D after calculation, that is 0.35 mm. So I calculated two things, change in length and change in diameter. Now let's go towards the last part, that is change in volume of the thin cylinder. So first of all, we will calculate the volumetric strain in thin shell. Volumetric strain in thin shell is given by the formula EV, E volumetric is equal to E2 plus 2E1. Where E1 is the circumferential strain and E2 is the longitudinal strain. Okay. So by knowing this circumferential strain and longitudinal strain, I can calculate the volumetric strain generated in thin shell. Now put the values. E2 here we calculated as E2 1.25 into 10 to the power minus 4. And plus 2 into E1 is 4.375 into 10 to the power minus 4. So after calculation, we'll get EV as 0.001 volumetric strain in the thin shell. Now, once again, I have to use the formula of volumetric strain, another formula. Volumetric strain is also given by the formula EV is equal to change in volume divided by original volume. So EV is equal to change in volume, I'll denote by delta V, divided by original volume as V. And now in the question we have to calculate change in volume, so I'll write the formula in terms of delta V. Delta V is equal to EV into V. Now put the values. Delta V is equal to EV into, this the V is the volume of the thin shell, and volume of thin shell is given by the formula area into length of the shell, area into length. So I will write delta V is equal to delta V is equal to EV as 0.001 into area of the thin shell pi by 4 into diameter square 800 square into length as 3000 in millimeter. All the quantities are in millimeter. Hence, after calculation, we'll get delta V as 1.507 into 10 to the power 6. Okay, 1.507 into 10 to the power 6, and as it is change in volume, its unit is millimeter cube. So by this we calculated change in volume of thin shell, change in length and change in diameter. So let's take a recap. Okay, this is the original problem. Initially we wrote the given data. First we calculated circumferential of hoop stress sigma 1, then longitudinal stress sigma 2, then circumferential stress E1, then longitudinal strain E2, and by knowing the formulas of E1 and E2, longitudinal strain E2 is equal to delta L by L, we calculated delta L. Circumferential strain is delta D by D, we calculated change in diameter delta D. And lastly, by using two different formulas of volumetric strain, EV is equal to E2 plus 2E1, we calculated volumetric strain, and EV is equal to delta V by V,